Lubigi wetland in Wakiso district has for some time now turned into a soft target for encroachers who reclaim it for settlement, setting up gardens, bricklaying, washing bays and other activities. This illegal occupants has seen more than 200 acres of this wetland destroyed. The Deputy Commandant of Environmental Protection Police Unit at the Ministry of Water and Environment, Okwash Simon Peter, has however sounded a strong caution to the encroachers to start vacating with immediate effect.
We've done enough sensitization, and some of the encroachers are saying that we have been overwhelmed, which means that they have been oversensitized. So when we start the enforcement, let them not start saying that we were never told.
The move by the Environmental Police Unit follows the expiry of the eviction notes, which was issued to the encroachers way back.
Some of the so-called rich people have clearances from NEMA. And the funny thing with NEMA is that NEMA gives clearance with so many conditions. Unfortunately, these people go and start the development without fulfilling those conditions. Not that NEMA is being irresponsible, but that the conditions set are not followed.
In this dialogue, which attracted officials from NEMA, police, Ministry of Water and Environment, politicians, among other stakeholders, the blame for the increased wetland loss was put on politicking, inadequate funds towards the environmental issues, failure to effectively sensitize the communities about the likely dangers of destroying wetlands, and reluctance in enforcement.
There is no specific grant for supporting sustainable natural resource management, and all what you keep doing and sending is mainstreaming, integrating, and all those issues. And if we keep on mainstreaming, integrating, we shall never manage these natural resources.
Why then is the police failing to handle the matter of environmental destruction by those who are doing it?
Unless we go back and rethink for the decentralization and how the implementation is done, we are going to continue dreaming and dreaming, and the dreams might not come.
One of the critical challenges in the transition to the green economy is finance. For instance, climate change. How people are going to introduce irrigation as opposed to rain-fed agriculture without the money.
Wetlands have continued to face extinction despite critical roles of filtering, retaining and controlling floods in and around the country. Juliet Namwaya, Urban TV.
And so